Hey guys, welcome back. So today's makeup tutorial is going to be on how to wear your foundation, how to do contour, how to highlight, all of that good stuff. I don't think we've done a video like this. If we have, it hasn't been for a good while, so I felt like it would be a really good idea to show you guys how to do this. I get so many people asking me how to apply foundation, how to highlight your face, how to contour your face, and so I really wanted to do an in-depth tutorial teaching you guys how to do that. So if you guys want to learn how to do all of that with your skin, then just keep on watching. Alright, so first we are going to get started with our skin. Before I put foundation on, I usually make sure that it's moisturized. So I always wash my face in the morning and then I put some moisturizer on it. And I usually use oils because my skin is so dry. And then I put sunscreen on. I always put sunscreen on my face and my chest every single day. Like, I don't care if it's winter or fall, I'm wearing sunscreen every single day. So I'm going to show you some of my favorite foundations right now, and fortunately, they're super inexpensive. At least two of them are. My ride or die right now has been the L'Oreal Infalliable, however you say that. And this one is the Pro Glow, and it's for normal to dry skin. And then they also have one that's matte for normal to oily skin. But because my skin is so dry, I always use this one, and I love it because it feels so hydrating. And then the other one that I was using for a while that I really loved was L'Oreal again, the Lumi Cushion. And it looks like this. And I really liked it because it's kind of the same thing like I was talking about the other one. Like, it's super hydrating on my skin and it's like a sheer coverage, but you can definitely like build it up to be more of a full coverage. The problem that I had with this, I felt like I went through it way too fast. So that was my only problem with that. But other than that, like, I love this foundation. And then another foundation that I've seriously been using for years. Before I like moved to Arizona, I did a lot of makeup on set. And this was the foundation that I used. I have like a bunch of different colors. That's just because I feel like it's a good basic foundation. It's just by MAC. It's the Match Master, and I really like it. I don't think it's super hydrating, but it's not super drying either. I feel like it's just kind of like right in the middle, and that's why I got it, because I just felt like it was a good foundation for multiple skin types. But today we are going to be going in with my favorite, the L'Oreal Infalliable one. I just stopped saying that because I don't know how to say it. And I just put a little bit on my hand like that. I don't know if you can see. Maybe a little bit more. Oh, that might be too much. It's okay. Then I go in with a stippling brush. These are usually my favorite brushes to apply my foundation. I like the flat surface of the brush because I like to push it into the skin. I just take a little bit on my brush and I kind of dot it around because I like a sheer coverage, but I definitely like to build it up as well. But I like to start off sheer and then slowly build it up. I don't want to just be like rubbing it all on there. It'll just take forever to like blend it in all nicely. So I just do like a little bit at a time and then just slowly build it up. And as you can see, I'm just going in circular motions. I'm not like sweeping back and forth. I'm just circling just around my whole skin just to make sure I get everywhere. And then I'll go back in and do the same thing, just to keep dotting until you have what you want. I'm just gonna be honest with you guys right now, like, the whole reason why I do voiceovers on my tutorials is because I feel like I cannot get out what I need to say. Like, I feel like I'm just flustered all the time and I get nervous. And like, if I'm sitting here talking to you face to face, let's talk makeup. I can teach you makeup. But if I get on the camera, all of a sudden, like, I feel like my words aren't making sense and I'm not making sense. And I'm like, I don't even sound like I know what the heck I'm talking about. So just bear with me as I try to teach you guys how to do this. But I just felt like this would be better than a voiceover so that I could make sure I got everything in there that I wanted to say to teach you guys. Another trick, I'm going to add a little bit more. But another trick that I like to do as well is I always will run my foundation like this down my neck. Sometimes on my chest, it just depends on like the shade, if my foundation is a little dark or a little light, I usually will just like run it down even farther. But that way you don't have the line right here. And I know like girls will be like, well, my foundation matches, so I won't have that line right here. Well, you still do. Like even when I've had foundation like perfectly match, you still can see that line of where your makeup is and then where your makeup isn't. And so I always just like to run it down just to make sure that it's all blended and then there's not that line. And then with matching your foundation, one thing that girls like always seem to forget is you don't want to match your foundation to your face. You want to match it to your chest. Because at least for me, usually my face is a lot wider than my chest. That's because I exfoliate my face like every single day. And so my face is always like super pale. So I always will go through my chest so that my chest and my face match. Because you don't want like a white face and like a tan body. That just will look weird. So once you have your foundation blended and you have like the consistency that you want, I added a little bit more coverage than I usually do. Usually I'll just do something super thin. But once you have it all blended in, then you move on to the contouring and highlighting. So usually when I'm contouring and highlighting, I just do like a little bit of powder. I'll explain all of this, but I'm gonna do something a little bit more dramatic just so that you guys can see like the placement and where I put everything, just so you guys have like a better understanding. So I usually will highlight before I contour, but I think I'm gonna do everything at once so that you guys can just like see the full picture and then I'll blend it all in. But usually I'll just put the concealer in, or my concealer on, to highlight my face, blend that all in, and then do my contour. So some of my favorite concealers, I actually haven't used a ton, surprisingly, but this one I really, really like, and it's just by Maybelline. And I think I've rubbed it off. I think it's the Fit Me Maybelline. I'll figure it out and I'll link it for you guys. But I've been using this one every single day, and I've really liked it so far. It's not super drying, but it's not super oily. Like, I feel like it's not like moving and creasing all day long. And then my ride or die concealer has been the MAC Pro-Longwear. This is another one that I've had in my kit for years, and I just love it because it does not move. I'm just currently not using it right now. I don't know why. So when you're shopping for your concealers, as far as like getting the shade that you want, it's kind of like what you prefer. Usually I wouldn't go any more than like two shades lighter than your skin tone. And that's if you want like that really pretty like Kim Kardashian glow where there's the light and the dark. Right now I've kind of been digging the little bit lighter but really close to my skin tone. And it just adds a little bit more like cover, and it just brightens your eyes a little bit and just brightens your face and highlights your face a little bit more naturally. But if you want something a little bit more dramatic, then yeah, go a couple of shades lighter than your skin tone. But like I said, I probably wouldn't take it past like two shades lighter, because then I feel like that's going to be really like light and bright and just look a little bit unnatural. But you're going to see that mine is definitely lighter than my skin tone right now, but not too dramatically light, if that makes sense. So I just take the end of this brush. If you don't have an applicator like this with your concealer, like if it's a concealer like this, I just squirt it out on my hand and use a concealer brush. This is like a flat synthetic concealer brush to apply it, and then I use my beauty blender. You'll see all that. So I just take it out and I just start applying it in like a, I'm not super perfect with it. I just kind of like sweep it in a triangle like upwards, you can see, and then just kind of like bring it down like that. There's like no like right or wrong way to apply it. I don't bring it up too close to my eye. I mean, right now, obviously I have makeup on. Either way, like I usually wear a shadow underneath my eye anyway, so there's no reason to bring it all the way up just because it's gonna cause more creasing and stuff when you get up closer to your eye. And the same thing, you can put as much or as little as you want. When we go to blend it in with the beauty blender, that takes off a lot of the product. So like, it's not a bad thing if you get too heavy-handed, because that beauty blender is going to take it right off. So then, I haven't been doing this every day, but like I said, I'm going all out for you guys. You can put some on your forehead, especially if you do a concealer that is too light, that is a couple shades lighter than your foundation. I would definitely bring it up here on the forehead just to even it out. If you're gonna do one lighter, you should highlight the whole face, not just like under the eyes, just because you're gonna really want to even it out and make sure that it's not just like under your eyes where you're lighter, because that'll just look weird, like a raccoon. Then I usually highlight my Cupid's bow, and I'll add some concealer around the nose. And the main reason why is I'm not trying to highlight the underneath of my nose, but I'm just trying to cover up the redness, because usually concealer is a lot thicker in consistency, and so it helps just to cover up that redness a little bit more. Then I'll add some on my chin, and sometimes I'll add some just down here, just like with whatever's left over on the brush. Like, that's not something super necessary, but I just will do it occasionally with a little bit of product. So now that I have this all on my face, I hope you guys can see the forehead. Usually I'll blend it in, but I'm going to go in with my contour so you can just see like everything together. So I'm going to go in with a cream contour. Usually I use powder contours. I don't know why I don't use cream. I guess I never really got into it, but I'm going to use a cream one just so you can see like more dramatically like where I put it, so you know where the placement is. And I'm going to be going in with this Morphe cream contour highlight palette. And like I said, I haven't used it a ton, so I'm not sure what shade. Like, I'm going to go in with this one and see if that's dark enough. And if it's not, then I'm going to go in with this one. But I just really want you guys to see the placement of this and where to be putting your contour. Oh, and then I forgot to say too, I know that this is like a dramatic look, and so I don't expect you guys to do this every day. Like, heck, I don't even do it every day. But this is just so you guys get an idea of where to put things, like where your placement should be. So if you want to just kind of follow this outline, you can do it as light or as heavy as you want it to be. Mine's heavier today just so you guys can see it, but usually I do something kind of following around the same lines as this, but I do it a lot lighter and a lot more natural. So keep that in mind. You don't have to do this dramatic, but this is just so you know where to put everything. So I'm going to get this. Oh, and this is the concealer brush I was saying that you could use for your eyes. Don't use the same one. Don't use the same one for your under eye and that. You don't want to mix the light and darks. And then I'm going to draw my contour. So what I usually do is, like, I usually don't like to do this. A lot of girls say do this, like the kissy face, you can see. But whenever I've, like, seen people do that, they always tend to bring it clear down here. You do not want your contour down here. You don't want to start looking like the Joker. So I will usually just, what I usually go by is the top of my ears. And then I just move down slightly. If you kind of like do this with your, this is so awkward. This like you can kind of see a little bit of definition. It's kind of the same thing as like, but like suck it in a little and you can kind of see that shadow. Then you can use that as like an outline to like, I usually stop like right here. You'll see. Oh, you can't see it. So I'm going to go darker. So I start from the top of my ear, and I move down. Are you guys seeing this? Oh my gosh, I guess I could do this really brown one. Oh my heck. I really want you guys to see this placement. Okay, hold on. We're starting over really quick, just because I need you guys to see this. I want you guys to see this placement, because so many girls come to me and say, I don't know how to contour. I don't know where to put it. You guys make it look so easy on your tutorials and stuff, but it's not that easy. It is easy. Just make sure you're doing it right. And that's why I really want you guys to see this. Okay, so I'm going in with this dark, dark, dark brown. So starting from the top of my ear, and I move down. And then obviously the placement doesn't have to be like perfect, because we're going to be blending it in. But I just want you to see where that is going. Just like that. Then do the other side. Same thing. I'm going to follow the top of the ear down. Just don't bring it down close to the corner of your mouth. You want to leave this space open. Then I usually will bring it up just to even it out and make everything even and blend it to the sides of my forehead. A lot of girls, I'll just show you, a lot of girls will bring it up to the tops of their forehead as well. What that does is just give the appearance of a smaller forehead. So keep in mind, where you're putting the dark is like sinking in the face. It's adding definition. It's adding depth. The highlight is bringing things out. So you want to put contour where you kind of want to initially sink in areas of your face to make them appear sculpted out or smaller. My forehead's already small, so I usually don't bring it up around here, but I'll show you just because most girls will want to do that. And then also, it's really important to avoid this area here with your contour. A lot of girls think that they're just going to blend it and then blend it all up through here too. And the problem with that is that if you get dark on this area, you're going to make that really heavy and your eyes are going to start naturally like drooping. So you want to keep the light highlight there so that it lifts the eye upwards and it gives your eye like a natural eye lift, if that makes sense. So we're going to go right in and I'm just going to add some dark. This is what I usually do. I just add it like there. But because I'm showing you guys the whole thing, I'm going to bring it up around the forehead, again, giving the appearance of a smaller forehead. I already have the world's smallest forehead. Don't really need a smaller forehead. But as you can see, like, I'm avoiding this area here. Like, I'm not, a lot of girls will think to take the contour and then drag it up all right here, but leave that space open. Leave it open. Then for the nose, usually I will contour my nose. And I will just go down the sides of it with the contour. And what that will do is give the appearance of a smaller nose. And I keep that highlight right in the center of the nose. Guys, I look so weird. And then sometimes lightly, which I'll do dark today, I will sculpt out my jawline. Really lightly powder. Just to add that sculpt out jawline. And that is what I do. So again, you can see where all the dark is and where the light is kind of like going away. I hope you guys can see it. I have light on my chin. I have light right here. I have light right here on my forehead just to really brighten up the face. So to blend it all in, I am going to go in with a beauty blender, and mine is filthy and I need to clean it so bad, but I'm so lazy. I love beauty blenders. They've come out with that new like silicone thing and I've heard great stuff about it, but I personally haven't tried it yet. If you have, let me know what you think because I would love to give it a try. But for now, I've been loving my beauty blender. Just make sure that it's wet. I stick it under the water and I squish it a bunch of times underneath the water, make sure it's really wet. And then I really wring it out, make sure there's not water in it, and then I just blend it. So I'm going to go get it wet and then I'll show you guys. Okay, and when blending it in, I'm going to start with my light first and just try to like avoid the dark as I start blending in the light. One, the light's been sitting there like forever, so it's going to be a little bit harder to blend in. But two, whenever you're like mixing brushes and stuff, if you do end up mixing brushes, where in this case I'm mixing the beauty blender, you want to start light to dark. Because you don't want the dark where the light is. And with the beauty blender, I am just going in patting motions and I move back and forth like this and I literally blend like crazy. Like I just, if I showed you this entire video, like the entire video would be me blending. And I've said that a million times, but it's so true. Just make sure to really blend that in and pat and pat and pat back and forth, back and forth. And usually I don't have makeup on, so like I'm like worrying that it's like getting up in my eyelashes and stuff here. But you, like I said, usually I do my skin first, or at least like I will leave my under eye undone until I put my skin on. That sounds so weird, putting my skin on. It's like really what it is though. And this is gonna like mess up my brows too. My brows. Just same thing, I'm just blending it all in, just patting, going back and forth until it is all blended in. Oh my gosh, if you guys hear bangs, my animals are bouncing around like crazy. My cat just like flopped off the couch. Calm down, Poppy. Then slowly move down here because I don't want to get that dark quite yet. Because I don't want them mixing. Because I definitely don't want a dark center of my face. And then also, like, I will go around, like, when I'm done, I'll go around my whole face anyway, just with the, after I've put my foundation on with my stippling brush, when I'm blending in my concealer, I'll take the beauty blender and I'll go around my whole face just to make sure there aren't, like, any lines from the brush or anything like that. The beauty blender is really good for that, leaving that flawless airbrush finish. I just don't like applying my foundation with it. I don't know. I just don't like it. That's all blended in. You can see like how it brightened up my face. But now if you just do that and you don't do a contour, you're gonna look really washed out. So you wanna add the depth and the shadows back into your face. But that's when we're gonna add the dark. And you guys, I am not like a fan of this. So bear with me as I'm playing with it and figuring it out. The idea though is, I'm just going back and forth on that line. I haven't brought it down and I haven't brought it up yet. You should never bring it down into here. You're gonna start looking like a skeleton. Like when I do my Sugar Skull makeup, I bring it down here so that like I'm a skeleton. But with your contour, I got too much hair, I don't like that. I'm just going back and forth, and then I'm gonna slowly start, as less product gets on the blush, the beauty blender, start patting it upwards into your cheekbone a little bit. You don't wanna bring it up here into the highlight area, but just slowly start blending it upwards. And it's okay if you end up bringing it too heavy down here, or you end up bringing it heavy down here, just get a clean concealer brush, or I use the other side of my blending my beauty blender. Gosh, I'm struggling. And just wipe it away. Like, don't like freak out about it. I'll always like flip my beauty blender around just like to make sure everything's getting blended in right. As you can see, going back and forth and just blending until it is blended in. And I'm gonna go over it anyway with the powder, so I don't care if it's like super harsh or dramatic. I just want you guys to be able to see like what's going on, but I'm gonna go in with the powder after and show you like how I do it with the powder. And then just start bringing it up here. Oh, the hair is everywhere. And up around the forehead. And add that shadow, really blend that in. And again, like if you guys are the ones who like cream contour, that's fine. If you're having a hard time blending it in because it's been sitting forever like mine has, just take your foundation brush and just go over it lightly. And that will just help blend it in a little bit more, see? And then it makes it look super natural. No panics. Something can always get fixed. I actually don't like the dark right here on the top of my brows either, because I want the top of my brows to be light so that they're like lifted up. So I usually don't bring it this far down here either. I'll show you with the powder. But there's a thought. Like I said, bear with me as I'm using the cream, because it's not my forte. See how that's blending in? Really nicely. I mean, it looks really pretty. Like, it's not that I hate how it looks. I guess I'm just too lazy. Like, I just want powder because I feel like I can just get it done and get it on really, really fast. And powder or cream, it's just like, you have to put it on, then you have to blend it, then blah, I don't know. Remember, stay away from here, and it's okay if you get a little bit down there. We can always clean it up. Just keep that in mind, like you don't want to bring the dark downwards. It really, like, contouring is amazing for your skin. Like, obviously, like, it makes your face look so much better and more flawless, but it really isn't that hard if you can just, like, make sure you're using the right products and make sure that you're applying it correctly. It really isn't that hard, and it will do so much for your skin if you can learn how to do that. And again, if you went too heavy-handed and you're like wanting it to go softer, just take that foundation brush that has a little bit of your foundation on it and just really blend it out. And I'm circling, I don't know why I keep saying that, circling, and then just lifting it upwards a little bit into my cheek. And then I'll do the sides of the nose. This is where it's gonna get tricky, because it's gonna bring down into my cheeks because I put a lot on the side of my nose. I'm probably gonna have to fix that. I'm gonna go right in with the foundation brush instead of a beauty blender for this. And like for me, like say, oh, that got a little too dark for me, just add a little bit more, like highlight. Don't stress. Everything can be fixed. And I usually go really light-handed under here too, because if you go, like, something this dark would be something maybe you'd want to do for like a photo shoot or something like that if you're doing any photo shoots. But I usually don't like going super dark because I don't want that line of foundation. Like, I don't want that difference between my skin and my neck, or my face and my neck. But it definitely is going to, you can see that it's defined my jawbone. So it is a really nice technique. Just really be careful not to go too heavy-handed on that. Really hard for me to say, like, because what I do is I just will go and I'll find, like, depending on how, like, my skin tone is, I go a good couple shades darker. So I will just look for, like, powders or, I mean, in your case, if you want to do creams that are quite a bit darker than your skin tone. You can see how mine looks. And it's actually, like I was using these light colors and it was too light. Like, these were too light. And they're quite a bit darker than my skin tone. I use this. That's dark. That's what I used for my contour. So keep in mind that you do want to go quite a bit darker with your contour, especially if you're wanting something more dramatic. But make sure that if you're using a powder, I mean, or a cream, make sure there's no shimmer in it or any kind of glitter or anything like that. Unless you're doing a bronzer. But for your contour, you want it to be matte. You want it to be really flat because you want to sink in those areas, like I said before. A highlight, a shimmer, that will bring it out. Like glitter and shimmer, that makes things stand out and come outwards. And we're trying to sink that in. So it's kind of like defeating the purpose. But with bronzers, I always think that's a little bit different. When I apply my bronzers, I'm just kind of applying it for like a light, like sun-kissed look. And if that has a little bit of like shimmer in it or sparkle in it, that doesn't bother me too much. Let me know if you guys want to see how I do that and I can show you. But I don't want to do that now, otherwise I'm going to like look super muddy. So now that we have that, you can see where everything is. I'm going to go in before like I really clean up areas and show you how to clean up. And I'll show you guys how to like bake and do stuff like that, which is a technique that I do like on photo shoot days or days that I do not want my makeup to move. But before I do that, I'll just show you really quick how to do the contouring again using a powder. Some of my favorite bronzers have been this. I've talked about this before, this NYX Matte Bronzer. It's really dark. This one is really, really dark. This is usually what I use in the summertime, but I'm going to use it today just so you guys can see. But like I said, any powder can work. Like, as long as it's matte and not like shimmery, just go and like find a powder that you like and just use it. I usually like to use the pressed powders, which is this, rather than a loose powder, which is like, if you don't know what a loose powder is, something like this, like where it's loose. And then this MAC one I use a lot of times in the summertime as well. It's just their mineralized skin finish powder. And that's really dark as well. Usually in the summertime. I'm tan in the summertime. I'm really pale right now. But I'm going to use this NYX one right now. And then I go in with the brush that I've been using right now is this blending brush. And I can't remember where I got it. I think I just got it on Amazon, but I'll link one similar. I just get a big fluffy brush and I do it. And that's just because I'm not being too precise, because usually like every day I'm just doing like a really natural contour bronzer type of thing. I'm not really carving it out. A brush that you could use if you're really wanting a nice carved out contour is something like, where is that one? This, or yeah, this one is really good. This is by Morphe. It is the MB30, and that's really nice for like really carve, because you can see how it would really, really, really carve it out. So I'll show you. So take your bronzer, your contour, whatever, your powder, and then get the brush in it. And then you're gonna do the same thing. See where you applied the cream? You guys, I'm gonna look like so muddy. And then you just start blending it the same way. But I kind of will start blending it upwards. A lot of times, even when I've used this for a really dramatic contour, I will switch brushes. So I will use this and just kind of like even it out like that. And then I will take my blending brush and then continue to just work it into the skin and blend it upwards and into my blush area until that is really blended. And that like left like a bam dramatic contour for you. So if you don't want that dramatic, which most cases, I don't know why you're going to, like, for a natural everyday, you're going to want that big of a contour, but you do you. I would just take this and go right in with it. Instead of carving it out, I would just go right in with it and then just start blending it like that. And you can see that it's darkening it. And I just follow the same thing, but I'm, like, a lot sloppier. It's not as precise. It's not as neat. And that's usually what I do. And that's because it's really light. It's really natural. It's kind of like a bronzing slash contouring. It's not, bam, defined. You can see the difference. You do whatever you prefer. It really depends on what you're going for. You can do both. I will do a really heavy contour sometimes, but for my most, like, everyday, I do something like this. That's a lot more natural, a lot more soft. And then you can take the powder and do the same thing where you just, like, lightly bring it up around the forehead. The same thing. I don't get a lot of powder usually for this because I don't care to have a really heavy contour up around the sides of my head and forehead. The whole reason why I'm doing it is mostly to even out and blend it out around my face just so it looks natural. And I'm probably going to, like, clean that up there above my brow so you can kind of see that, like, give the natural eye lift. But I'm going to go and add a heavy contour now to this side just so it's evened out so I don't walk around, like, because I've got, like, a girl's night tonight. I'm going to look so muddy. Okay. Let's see. This brush, like, is gold. And Morphe has really, they're really inexpensive. Like, they're not expensive brushes. So check them out online and see if you like it. Because it is going to make your contouring life, like, easy peasy lemon squeezy. Who says that nowadays? But you can see, like, I'm not bringing it down here. I'm stopping it, like, right here. You do not need it down that low. And then I will take my brush, my blending brush, and just start blending it. And you blend it upwards, but not too high up into this area, but just blend it, pat it, go back and forth, all that fun stuff. All right, there you have it, the heavy, heavy contour, like, wow, my cheeks, I'm skinny. And then if you did, again, if you do get carried away and your bronzer ends up coming too close to your mouth or, like, around here and you don't want it here or it starts coming down here, there are ways to clean that up. And I'm going to show you that along with baking. So I'm going to take this NS Minerals powder. It's a translucent powder, and I actually haven't used this one on for baking, so I hope that it works out good. This, I do use a loose powder to bake. I don't use a pressed pigment to bake. And I'm going to take my damp beauty blender, and I'm going to go in and get, like, a fair amount. And this is a way to clean it up and just pat it down, because this is the highlighted area. This is where you don't want contour. It will work with me here. You can kind of see what's going on, though, at least. And see how that cleaned it up? And then I'm going to leave the powder on there for a little bit. Do the same thing on the other side. This baking, I don't know if you guys have seen it. I'm sure most of you have seen it. It's a pretty big thing. Is awesome because your makeup, if you bake, it will not move. It will not move all day long. The celebrities do it. They have to do it. So I'm going to add some right here, just some powder right here, just because of my smile lines, and just to clean up any of that contour that might have gotten carried away. And then the same thing under the eyes to bake the eyes. This will help so your concealer will not crease. The only problem is for people like me with dry skin, this can be really drying. Because really, like, what it's doing by, like, letting it sit here on the skin without blending it away and letting it, like, dry, it's like cooking the skin, kind of. And it's like making it stay in place, like it's baking it so that it's, like, does not move. But powder is very drying on your skin well as more drying on your skin. That's why usually people will use it to set their makeup, because one, it helps it stay longer, and two, it helps the oils because it absorbs the oils. So like when I do makeup on like clients and stuff, I put powder on their skin because you don't want a shiny face. And that absorbs those oils right up. For me, I want a shiny face because my skin is so dry. So every time I see shine, I'm like, yes, yes, the shine, the oils. I have oils on my face. And then around, I'll do it around the forehead too, because I'm like running out of this powder and I didn't even use it that much. I struggled putting it on. The powder is not cooperating and it's like practically gone. So I try to get the best that I can. I hope you guys can see where the powder is still sitting. So it's still sitting underneath my eyes. I've got a little bit of powder there. Maybe I'll just get another. I don't really like this powder, so I'm not even going to like show you guys. But just so you guys can see it more. Like, I feel like it's not showing up enough. Watch, this one's like almost gone too. There we go. That's what it baking. Okay, after letting it sit there for a while, you're just going to go and brush it off. And I am just going in with this fluffy blending brush by MAC. It's the 150 brush. And it cleaned up that contour. It set the makeup so it's not going to move. Another way that you can clean up the contour without like putting a powder is just taking a flat concealer brush like this one. I don't know what this one is either. I get all my brushes like off Amazon. But it's just a flat concealer brush. And I would get some concealer on it. And you can take some like light concealer and just do that and then blend it in. That's another way you can clean up your contour if you want that really harsh, dramatic contour. Where'd that brush go? Oh. And it did. I got it all, the powder all over. This brush is shedding. I hate brushes that shed. But like, so now that I let it sit and like bake like that, all my wrinkled areas, so like under my eye, my smile line, my forehead, like the makeup is not gonna crease in those areas. Like, it's amazing. It really works. It will last all day and it will not crease all day long. So I think I told you guys everything that I can think of as far as like doing your skin, your contour, your highlight area, baking. So I hope that this was informative for you guys. Let me know if you have any questions or if I missed anything and I can try to fix that for you. But I can show you guys how to apply blush. Usually I don't wear a lot of blush. If you guys have watched my makeup tutorials, you'll see like I'm not a blush girl. They're really pretty. I just have never really gotten into it. Maybe I will someday. Hopefully I get into it someday because I see so many pretty looks with blush. But I'm always just like, I just like a bronze. So I just always will drag up that contour into a more bronzy look rather than a blush. But I will show you today how to do a blush if that's what you guys want to do and where to place that. So I'm going to show you with this Morphe palette here. And I'm just going to get like a really natural blush because like again, I'm not really used to the brights. Like I want to do something simple. So I'm going to go with this and it doesn't have a lot of shimmer in it. Blushes are definitely something you can add the shimmer to. It is really, really pretty. I really love like the corally shimmery ones like during the summertime. I actually will wear those sometimes during the summer because it's like really pretty on your tan skin. And then you just go in with a fluffy brush. This is just like a really inexpensive, cheap one that I got like Claire's. And you just dip it in. And then instead of like smiling, you know, and like applying your blush, don't smile because think about it. Like when you smile, that moves down. So you don't want it down here. You want it to bring your cheeks up. You want your cheeks to get a lift. So I usually will start it like right here and kind of slowly start blending it and then dust it upwards. Well, I guess not up, but outwards. And really kind of blend it down into that contour area. Don't bring it up too high up here. You want to leave that nice and bright. I'm adding more so that you guys can see it. This is like a lot of blush for me. And it's the same thing. If you get too heavy-handed with the blush and you're like, shoot, I put way too much blush on, then just take either your big contour brush and just start blending that in. I usually do this anyway just to like really soften that blush. But then you can even go in with your foundation and dab it and kind of blend it in more. So don't be afraid, like if you accidentally get too heavy-handed, there are easy ways to fix it. So same thing, starting in like this area here. You can see where that is. I'm not starting over here. I want this really light and bright. I'm not smiling. But if I do smile, you kind of see that that's kind of like where it is. I'm just kind of circular motions and sweeping and brushing it upwards. Outwards, not upwards, not into the eye. And now we're going to go into my favorite step, which is the highlighting, the shimmery highlighting glow part. Oh, I can't live without a glow every single day. I've got to have that glow. Okay, favorite highlighters. So I am going to show you where I apply my highlight and how to apply the highlight. Oh my gosh, I forgot my glow kit. I got to grab my glow kit. So for the highlight, I grab my glow kit. This has been like my favorite, and I know it's not available right now and she's got other ones, but they're all amazing. You will not be disappointed. So I love these colors here. I use this one a lot during the summer. It's really a little bit too much for me right now where my skin is so fair. My favorite have been these three right now. My favorite like goldy highlight right now has been in this eyeshadow palette, the TIGI High Density or TIGI Cosmetics High Density palette. It's this shade right here. It's an incredible face highlight. I love it. I'm wearing it on my brows right now. I love it. So keep that in mind. You don't have to just do like, you don't have to go and buy like a highlighter specifically for highlighting. You can use an eyeshadow if you want. Usually I prefer to do one with shimmer in it. I don't like having like a flat highlight. For the under eye and the concealer and that kind of highlight, yeah, I like to keep it flat. But when I want this, that glow, I don't want it flat. So speaking of the shadows, this one is called Honey. It is a loose eyeshadow from Ulta. And it's really like light and white. So it's really pretty for people with fair skin. So when you're fair, this is a really good one. This is like bam in, like bring out the highlight. I love this Urban Decay Naked Illuminated one. It's a really pretty glow and it has like really pretty sparkly in it. So it's going to add some sparkle, not just like that pretty shimmer highlight, but an actual like sparkle. And I love sparkles. And then my last but not least favorite is this Bobbi Brown Beige. It's a Shimmer Brick Compact. And I love using this one because it's more bronzy. So I have like my cool highlights for like my cooler makeup looks, and then I have like my warm goldy highlights for like my warm makeup looks. And I love doing the warm makeup looks and like the warm glows for during the summertime because they look really pretty on tan skin. But today I'm going to show you my little cocktail of highlights that I do like for almost every look right now. So since I usually don't wear blush, I go in with Hard Candy. And I put that in the blush area, and I'll show you. I'm just going to go over the blush with it, but you can just like see like, oh, it's so pretty. I apply it with my Real Techniques setting brush. It's been my favorite highlighting brush right now. I just like dip it in, get a good amount, and then I just lightly, like I'm not pushing hard, I'm just lightly circling and then like bringing it outwards a little bit. Like I said, I'm kind of treating it like it's a blush. So I'm kind of putting it over the blush in that blush area because it's a really pink highlight. I hope you guys can see this. I hope you guys can see this. So like I said, it's not like it's a dramatic blush. That's why I like it. It's a highlight. It is a highlighter. And so where you're really gonna see it most is when the light hits your face. That's when you're gonna see that pink there. It's like looking straight on, like you're not gonna be like, oh my gosh, she has blush on. But if I start moving around, you're gonna see the shimmer. So then I go in with, and I start slowly building. I'll go in with Starburst. Like I said, guys, I have a little cocktail. Like I just can't live without my highlights. And then I'll apply that a little bit higher because that is a lot lighter of a highlight, so it doesn't need to go down on the blush area. that can go up a little bit higher, but I'm still laying it over the blush or where I put that last color. And I'm using really light motions. Like, I'm very softly touching my skin and just dusting it on there. Like, I am not pushing it and rubbing it in. I'm dusting it on there. Then I'll go in with Crushed Pearl, this one, and apply it over the same area. Again, you guys remember, I'm crazy with my highlights. Like, this is if I want a really dramatic highlight. Most days, like every day, like I'm throwing on like a quick makeup look, I'll just pick one highlight and I'll just keep layering it until it's where I want it to be. But I just do something really natural. But if I'm doing a full face of makeup, I will play around and mix highlights to just get a really pretty glow, because like I am obsessed with this glow. I am obsessed with it. Just bring whatever's left over on the brush. I just kind of bring it down the center of my face. And then I will go in and I highlight my nose, the top of my nose, and my Cupid's bow. And that just adds like a really pretty glow to your face. I love it. I love the nose highlight. And now I think we're all finished with the skin. I showed you guys how to do the contour, highlight the face naturally. Then I showed you how to highlight with this pretty shimmer, bring that glow into your skin. I told you guys how to bake. So after that, after your makeup is all done, I gotta go in and fix my eye makeup a little bit because it got a little crazy. Then you would take a setting spray and you would just spray it, and that's gonna help, like the baking's already gonna secure your makeup in place, but the setting spray is gonna help secure it a little bit more and add like a little bit more hydration back into your skin. This is just Ulta makeup setting spray. You just find one that you like. And it's just not gonna move. I hope that you guys found this video useful, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe and let me know what you think in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching.